Hello everyone, it's Thumper the Rabid Rabbit. Today I wanted to do a quick demonstration of how to do a day-night automatic light for your base that is solar powered so that you can have light inside of your base at night instead of it being dark and running into everything or using flashlights or low-grade powered tuna can lamps and so forth. Since the hanging light now is electrically powered, this is a basic setup you can use to take advantage of that. What I have here is a large solar panel, an electrical branch, and a blocker that'll make use of the small rechargeable battery. So you only need these four electrical components to make this work. Since I'm going to assume you're new to electricity here when I explain this, I'll try to go step by step. The solar panel has an output handle on the side. You connect this to the bottom of this electrical branch. The electrical branch does splitting of power by branching off a certain amount that you've configured and then taking the leftover and sending it out the power out. By default, the electrical branch is configured to take off 2 units of power and send the rest on through the power out. The blocker is designed to stop the pass-through of power anytime you apply power to the block pass-through handle. So here you'll see we've got the solar power coming in. It comes into the bottom of the branch. A little bit of power comes off here to activate the block pass-through that turns off the battery so we can charge it. And all the remaining power goes into the battery input to charge the battery. So the light is off, sun's up, everything's working fine here. And then as soon as the sun goes down, which I will simulate by just disconnecting this power here, you'll see that there's no longer power to activate the blocker, so it's going to allow power from the battery to pass through to the light, and there you go. You'll see the battery starts ticking down. It's just, it runs like a clock. Batteries run like a clock, so it's just going to tick down for 15 minutes until it dies. This is a perfect basic night lighting system for your base that's solar powered. The only downside to this particular configuration is the light's not going to come on until there is no power left coming in from the sun. And if you've played Rust at all, you know that your base can tend to get pretty dark around sunset, well before nighttime. And it tends to be pretty dark in the morning before sunrise. So I'm going to show you a variation of this setup that you can use to configure your lights to come on from sunset to sunrise, so you don't have to deal with that darkness inside of your base during the sunset and sunrise periods. Slightly less efficient, but it still works out really well. It uses the exact same components. Ignore this branch, I'm just using this for demonstration. You still take your solar panel into the bottom of the branch, and then instead you flip these from the other configurations. So send the power out, the leftover power, to the block pass through, and take the branch and run it into the battery input, and then configure this to a number that represents the threshold of when you want your light to turn on. I'd recommend always keeping this above 10 so that you can charge your battery fully. I set this to 16 just as a demonstration value, but what happens here is as the sun begins to set and the power from the solar panel begins to drop, at some point the power is going to go from 20 to 19 to 18 to 17 as the sun goes down, and as soon as it hits 16, all that 16 goes to the battery. There's nothing left to come to this blocker, so it will turn on. So I'll demonstrate that. I'm just going to go here and say sun's coming down, we're down to say 15 units coming in. You can see the light turned on because there's no longer enough power to go down the branch and have anything left over for the blocker. So with nothing left over for the blocker, it's now open and you can see the lights on. But one thing you'll notice is that this clock doesn't tick down quite in real time. And that's because as long as the sun is still up and we're getting a little bit of power here, all of that power is still gonna go down the branch first, and it's still gonna go to powering the battery, to charge the battery. Now, one of the tricks you need to know about batteries in Rust is they only charge at 80%. So this can take 10 in and 10 out. As long as we have 10 units of power coming in, it's going to charge at 80%, which means this clock is going to run at 20% of normal speed. You're putting some juice in while the lights are using the juice out, you can't ever stop this clock. You can't put enough in because of the inefficiency to charge it while it's under load, but it slows down the clock, which is great in this scenario because you wanted your lights to come on at sunset and go off at sunrise, so they're going to run longer than this scenario. But they also continue to get a little bit of charge longer anytime the sun is up. So they'll have a longer lifespan on the battery. So again, if you want a basic setup, just run this configuration right here, the power out to the battery, the branch to the blocker. This is day-night trigger. And if you want a little more advanced configuration, run the power out to the blocker and configure a value off of here that's probably somewhere between 10 and maybe 15, depending on when sunset and sunrise happens on your solar panel on your server. And this is a sunset to sunrise instead of a day-night trigger. Placement of your solar panel will matter in this scenario also. Try to point it towards the daytime sun. Or if you want it to turn on a little bit earlier in the morning, point it a little more to the east, or if you want a little later in the evening, point a little more to the west. But that's a topic for another day. But these are two effective examples for making a day-night or configurable sunset to sunrise basic solar-powered light system. And that little battery with 10 units of power should run up to 4, or in most cases 5 lights in your base. So that's a great way to get a little bit of light without needing low grade and to manage all those lamps anymore. So hopefully that is helpful to you if you are new to Rust electricity and just need some basic lighting in your base to get started with. Good luck, and don't suck.